You hacking Josh?
100%.
All right, welcome guys to episode 4. Yes, episode 4? Yeah, episode 4 of Slime Fun. Welcome, Josh.
Thank you. Hello, everyone.
And what we're going to do today is we went through, last episode we went through doing some work on our XP machines, our XP grinds, our farms, our mob farms. As you can see behind me here, let's get in the right spot. We're doing a bit of work on our iron golem farm there, and you see I've put some redstone blocks down around the edges of that pod, and I've got a rail system through there, and I'll show you that a little bit later on if we've got some time. So I'll be doing a bit of work on that. I haven't done any more work on the blaze farm yet, because I think what we want to do, Josh, is we want to get best XP we can and make the best one, and the best one for XP, and some people might disagree, they might think, nah, Blaze is better. Really, the best one is the Enderman.
Yep.
So what we might do today is we might go and build ourselves an Enderman farm. And I've got a really good design. This design isn't mine. It actually came from a young fella on another server. I can't remember his name now, but the actual concept was Ethos Lab. I don't know, you know Ethos, don't you?
Yep.
Yeah. So his idea was it came to, and it had to do with the Endermite, and it's probably the most popular one on Minecraft now with the latest version. So let's head off to spawn, Josh. And before we do, we need a heap of resources. So what resources have you got, Josh?
What resources? Yeah. 47 cobblestone.
You've got 47 cobblestone to build an Enderman farm.
Yep.
Right. What about dirt, Josh? You got dirt? Go and get some dirt, Josh.
I'll go and get some dirt.
We need to build a bridge away from the island to build our Enderman farm. And while Josh is going to do that, I want to show you something that we have on this server. And it's called Player Vaults. Now, if you look at my inventory here, notice I've only got a bit of wood, some torches there, and that's it. To build the Ender farm, but what I really have is if I go in here and type in /PV1 player vault 1 and go enter, I also have this this vault here in my inventory as well, and I've given these player vaults to each rank. So when you hit the rank of citizen, you get one player vault. When you get to the rank of cohort, which is the next one, you get an extra play vault, and you get the same. You get one extra play vault every time you get up a rank. So when you get to Tribune, you'll end up with five or six play vaults, which is a whole swag of extra inventory storage you get. So keep on voting for the server, and you'll get 100 votes, gets you an extra rank. Each 100 votes gets you up an extra rank. Or if you want to be kind to me, you can actually go and buy the ranks on the website. Just type /buy and it's there. And while you're doing stuff for the server, don't forget to hit like and subscribe to the YouTube channel. It helps us out. We need to get 10,000 so we can start earning a little bit of pocket money off these videos. All right. Nice plug there. Okay, you ready to go and get it? Get going, Josh? All right, so let's go to spawn. Here we are. There he is. So here we are at spawn. This is, one of Josh's huge creations, very detailed. And what we've done is we've actually put a portal to spawn underneath. So let's go to one of the corners here.
Yep.
And don't worry, the dragon's already been killed. We'll do a bit of dragon fun and respawn him a little bit later on.
Yep.
Head into the center here. So you see those there, the tunnels out of spawn over here, over there you can see. If we go inwards, into the corner here, we have our tunnels into spawn. Hey, Josh, these lights are off again, eh? Check this out. All right, so let's jump in.
Yep.
And here we are. Oh, the Ender Dragon's here. What the?
Oh. Problem?
Someone must have spawned the Ender Dragon back. All right, let's go kill it.
Fire?
Oh, one more hit. Wait till he gets close before we hit him, because he's. I think one more shot will nail him.
There we go.
Got him. And we get some XP for it too, which is awesome.
Yep. It doesn't look like a lot of XP there.
mine, stop!
It only brought me up one level, though.
Okay, so what we need to do now is we need to get as low as we possibly can. Oh, we need a bit. Did you bring any water?
No. This.
All right, I'll go get some water. Don't look at them. Usually, if you, here's a pro tip for you guys that haven't got a lot of experience with this sort of stuff. If you keep worried about Enderman attacking you on the end, stick a pumpkin on your head.
Yep.
Because pumpkins disguise you from Enderman, so you can look straight at Enderman and they won't do anything because you've got a pumpkin on your head. So if you don't know about that, whack a pumpkin on your head and crack on.
Also, so, I didn't know if you knew about this one, Dean, but your tactics are a lot more better, but if you look at their legs, they won't attack you as well.
Yes, yeah. Hitting their legs, they'll attack you, but they won't spawn away.
Just looking at them, they won't.
Oh, yeah, just looking at the legs, yeah. But yeah, if you attack their legs only, they won't spawn. They'll just keep attacking you.
Yeah, yeah, they won't TP away.
But if you hit them from the head and torso, they'll keep TPing away from you. But just hit them in the legs. All right, so give me a sec. I'm going to go back home, and I'm going to go and get some water so that we can get down to a low level. Now, what we need to do, I've had a look at the DIN map. We need to go north.
North?
Yeah, west, north. So, head north of the... because there's other people have been on the server, and they built Enderman Farms as well. And I don't want to run into their Enderman Farms.
Yeah.
So, if we go north, we should be pretty sweet. Another pro tip for you guys here is, if you do build one of these, I'd suggest you have a set home available to yourself, because once you get this set up into the area you are, you don't want to be coming to the Enderman spawn point and having to travel there all the time. How did you get down there, Josh? You just jumped.
I enderpelled.
Oh.
Just quickly threw an enderpell all as well.
Yeah, that'll do. Whoa. That'll do. I just increased my acrobatic skill by falling.
Yep.
Good on you. MCMA, what a legendary idea. Alright, so here's a... So what level are we at? We're at 34, so we've got a little bit to go down. Let's get rid of F3. Alright, so there's a water drop. You've got the dirt, Josh. We need to go down as low as you can. You don't have to go down to zero, just as close as you can.
Yep.
And we'll head down from there. I'll destroy the blocks as I come down to you.
Yep.
Just let me know when you're down as far as you go, and I'll take the water out.
Wow, this is scary, isn't it?
Yeah. What was that? Take the water out now, Josh?
No, don't take the goddamn water.
Yeah, don't. You don't. A lot of people sit there and say, "Get to level one," but I always fail at level. Trying to get to level one. So, get us, you know, two or three, whatever you're comfortable with.
Uh huh. That's all I'm going. That's go. Oh God, I'm so close to falling. Then I'm coming back up now.
All right, set your platform up. Set your platform up and stay down there.
Okay. Yeah.
And I'll come down. I'll stop the dirt. I'll stop the water. And I'll dig down.
Alright, we're all good.
Okay. Stop the water now.
Yep.
Okay, so I'm coming down now.
It's a Sky Factory all over again.
Oh, I've been tempted to prank you a little bit, but I thought, no, we'll get some stuff out. Maybe later we'll prank you.
We gotta keep inventory on this one, or no?
Don't think so.
Let's not test it. All right.
We won't test it. I might actually do it, because we do want to do a little bit of trolling on people and stuff, and I don't want to sort of get them all shirty, because people do get a little bit antsy when we lose stuff.
I mean, I've got a full Tribune kit here, and that is, you know, the editor.
So now we need to go north. What we need to do is go out around about, I think the minimum is about 138 blocks or 128 blocks to stop the enemy from spawning on the island. I like to go around about 200 or 250, but with the new end setting up with the islands, I just basically get the island out of focus. So once I can't see the island anymore, that's when I start to build everything.
Cool.
Around about 200 to 250. All right. So, Josh, you got the dirt. You start pulling out. I'll start to destroying the dirt. So we're traveling.
All right,
so we've come out of probably a couple hundred blocks. I'm not quite sure how many it was. The island, the Enderman Island, is over that way. and we have the edge of the rest of the islands over that way somewhere, so it's around about halfway. But you want to be in a spot where you can't see anything, right, and nothing can spawn. So Josh, what we need to do now is we need to make slabs. Now, it's a good thing I brought some wood with me, because we need to make a crafting table. So let's just plonk this down there for now.
Man, this is...
And...
By definition, Sky Factor here. Everything's going on the sides and stuff. And...
Yeah, yeah. Just don't stand too close, mate. I might be tempted.
Okay.
okay, so let me open up my play vault. And we'll grab some... we've got some stone bricks already. So what we're going to do is we're going to make some slabs. Now, we need to build our level platforms at the half height, at the slab height, so Enderman won't spawn on it.
Alright,
so... those... Oh, did I just...
There you go.
Range entries full. Dang it! Get rid of that. I've still got some here. There. Okay.
Right.
So, just... let me just duck over here. And so we'll start here. That's right. So we go there. We come down. There we go. So when we build that high... okay, Josh, you can get rid of that dirt now, mate.
Yep. I'm not going to get a shovel out.
Okay, here's some slabs. So it needs to be 25 by 25.
25 by 25.
It's a big platform. But there's a reason behind it, and it's a little bit of forward thinking when we do this. So, what we're making room for?
Where are we starting from?
Let's make the crafting table the center.
Alright.
And the reason I do it this way is I make room for enchanting rooms, enchanting tables, and bookshelves. And the way this is set up is it allows other players to share the Is that how many is that, Josh?
25, I assume.
Yeah, so half of 25 is what?
Okay.
Oh, for some, I feel like hitting you off the edge right now.
No, please.
So, out 12, mate. Out 12.
No,
four. So, we're going to make it, 25 by 25. And what that does is it's going to be like a cross pattern. So, we have the center. And then we have 1, 2, 3, 4 out. Then I usually make about a three wide space for a walkway, and then I'll have then I'll make ref room for the enchanting room, so a 3 by 3 by 3 bookshelves, which is 1, 2, 3, and then one for the back edge, and then the wall. So yes, it's 25 by 25. So we just keep making it, and we'll get this done. So, hey Josh, do you pick your nose?
No.
It's funny because I don't understand how people say they pick their nose, because you know I was just born with mine.
You know what? These are amazing.
Okay, job, here we go. So that's 25 by 25, guys. So now we're kind of restricted on how high we build these platforms now. And this is going to be the absolute base platform. This isn't where we actually have the Enderman dropping on it. We have to do another one of these, 2.5 high. So that's half. That's 1.5. That's 2.5 there. So we can go. That should be the top. If we go one more to there, that should be a half height again now. If we just climb up there and have a quick check. Get a little bit of parkour here.
Nice.
If we go F3, so that's 4.5. So that's a half height. So the Enderman won't spawn on that level either. Okay, so what we need to do now is build another one 25 by 25 at that height there. Okay. So do you need some more need some more, let's go.
Yeah,
and make some
yeah,
more.
I can go back and get some more if we need some.
Oh, I've got a heap of stuff here. I'll just make some more stone and stuff out of my play vault. I've got heaps of it here.
Alright.
Okay, so we're gonna make it again, guys. We'll be back in another couple of hours if we get this right and we All right, guys, I'm going to end this this tutorial at this point. I've been editing it for a little while now, and I just cannot get it down into one video length. So I'm going to make it a two-parter. I'll be publishing them both at the same time, so there'll be one after the other, so you won't miss out there. But yeah, the length of it is just a little bit too long to make into one video. So I'm going to cut it there. If you're liking the series, please hit the like and subscribe button and click that notifications bell so you can get notifications of when I put new videos up. I put these up at least once a week if I can get the editing done in time. And I'll see you on the next tutorial, which should be just below this one, or just the next one in line. So I'll see you later.